Hi everyone, the topic today is time and day off. Many are not clear on overtime issues. Overtime is more than working more than 8 hours a day. The extra hour counted as an extra overtime that must be paid time and day off. For example, if your hourly billing is $50 an hour, the time and day off is apply for overtime, that will be around $75 an hour per hour must be paid for the ninth hour, the extra hours. That's one. And there is a rule, there is an act, Fair Labor Standards Act, that was passed in 1938. Because of that act, most of the ES clients implicitly understand and they follow the rule. And many good companies pay time and day off. Otherwise, you have to agree with the, come for an agreement with the client and vendors and the employer. Otherwise, the clients may not be liable for paying the time and day off. That you must be very clear. Point one. Solution is, you have to, just like I explained, you have to come an agreement with the client, vendor, and employer. Upfront you have to ask them, is there any overtime? If it is overtime, so do you pay time and day off? You have to ask your employer and vendor. Like in one of the videos and audios and posts I explained, better have one layer and American layer, then life is easier on H-1B. Otherwise you have to face lot of issues. So 8 hours a day, Monday to Friday, 40 hours, 160 hours a month, 2000 hours in a year. For example, you work 3000 hours in a year. So the rest of the 1000 years, example I am quoting, so must be paid time and day off. They will pay if it's a good company. If not, you have to come for an agreement. If not, you can't help it. You can't complain. Layers business, they feel it's a business. So ESAC, that's why these days they have come for asking for H-1B client approval letter. You cannot complain to anyone, that's what. And the other point, H-1B wiki page, they posted one of my posts as a guest post, and I received a lot of comments. People are working from companies, so don't misunderstand. If you are an H1, if your non-immigration status is H1B, then the H1B rules apply. For example, there is a, I'm just showing item, this is a driving license manual book. Okay, that manual book apply for anyone in this country, right? Just because we came from India or other country, we don't follow our traffic rules, right? The same way H1B, if you are on H1B, same H1B rules apply. That is where people misunderstand and writing the bad comments. That's the reason I'm explaining this point. So the same H1B rules apply, that is to 8 hours a day, overtime must be paid time and day off. That you have to be very clear. And because of these OT and other issues, if you are not aware of it, then you will face a lot of issues. That's the reason I'm recording this video, and thanks for watching this video, and I hope this would be informative.